Assalamu alaikum viewers, I am Meer Shima and I once again welcome you to P News English Headlines. Two unidentified militants killed in wrong raid gunfight. August 5 decision a big blunder. Ladakh shuts down and demands restoration of statehood. National Conference Vice President Umar Abdullah questions government on different laws for J&K Ladakh on jobs and land rights. BJP activist PSO along with associate go missing with two weapons in Kupwara. India sending medical aid to Afghanistan is a sign of thaw in bilateral relations. Pakistan boycotts Biden summit. Imran Khan calls for strengthening ties with US. UAE shuts down China facility under US pressure, top official confirms. Land passbooks to be issued in Jammu and Srinagar from January next year. Government reduced compliance burden for GST taxpayers, Finance Minister Sita Raman. $717 million defense deal signed between Australia and South Korea. Now let's go through news headlines in detail. Two unidentified militants were killed in a gunfight between militants and security force in Rangrit area in uptown Srinagar. Salman Nizami stated 2 years after revocation of Article 370, Ladakh shuts down to demand restoration of statehood and special status. He further said, people are suffering here and they claim return of their rights. The United Arab Emirates recently ordered to stop work on a Chinese facility in the country after American officials stated that Beijing intended to use the site for military purposes, according to a top UAE official. Last month, reports had emerged that the Biden administration managed to halt the construction of a secret development inside of a Chinese shipping port in the UAE, one of the US's closest Mideast allies, after intense pressure from the US. Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan asked the delegation to strengthen the ties between the two nations in a bid to prevent a humanitarian crisis in Afghanistan. Pakistan valued its long-lasting relationship with the United States and was committed to expanding it in all spheres, particularly in the economic dimension. The Chief Secretary directed to digitalize all revenue land records of Jammu and Kashmir by 26 January 2022 and of all the districts by 15 August 2022. The department was further directed to ensure end-to-end digitalization of all its process to provide online facilities to people for applying and receiving copies of revenue records through a web portal, besides ensuring that a copy of every government order is also available on the departmental website. In a good news, the Ministry of Finance on Sunday announced new relaxations for the goods and service tax payers. Talking to Twitter, the ministry said that taxpayers with annual aggregate turnover up to Rs 5 crore are not required to file the reconciliation statement in form GSTR 9C for fiscal year 2020-21 onwards. The Taliban have welcomed India's offer of help and have consistently said they value the assistance of all countries in the region. Indeed, it was due to the intervention of the Taliban that Pakistan changed its mind and allowed India to send wheat to Afghanistan through the Wagah border, which is the shortest route from India. However, this consignment has not yet been sent. The logistics required to send the 50,000 metric tons is complex, including paperwork and an interchange of trucks at Wagah border. The nearly 3-year-long absence of trade relation between India and Pakistan has led to the dismantling of systems at the land border. The medicines were sent on a return flight of a plane that brought evacuees to India last week. That was all for today. See you tomorrow in next bulletin. Till then, take care of yourself. Fi amanillah.